Let's move down to the lower salary tier and talk about Tyrrell Hatton. And Brandon, Hatton hasn't played in a while. He won an event towards the end of the fall, hasn't played since January 1st, though. And that's a pretty long layoff for a golfer. However, Hatton has done really well at Chapultepec in the past. So what do you see with him when trying to balance those two conflicting sentiments around him?
Yeah, I mean, there's going to be risk here, but you kind of have to take a little bit of risk, even though it's a no-cut event. You want someone who has some high-end upside, and Hatton fits that bill. He's one of 18 golfers, by my count, in the field to have played here all 3 years. He has good finishes in them. That's obviously why we're talking about him. Started with a 10th and a 3rd, 19th a year ago. He's gained strokes tee to green at Chapultepec in 10 of 12 rounds, tied for the best mark among those 18 golfers. So it's not just the putter. We kind of learned of Hatton being a good putter, but he's got a really well-rounded game at this point in his career. He's got good recent form. It's just not that recent. Last played in Dubai, undergone wrist surgery since then. Prior to that event, when he was 46th, he had a win and four more top 20s. So the only real concern is the layoff and coming back from wrist injury. But Hatton's someone who's dealt with a lot of wrist injuries in the past. I'm not saying that we can be dismissive of it, but at $9,100 with this course form, a course that does kind of require some course knowledge, I'm going to go there.
Yeah.
My question is, my internal question is, like, can I trust him in a cash game? Because the price is so good.
Right.
But what are your thoughts on Hatton?
I think he's a really good tournament play because we talk about making the assumption game. And, like, we want to make realistic assumptions. I think it is a realistic assumption you could make that Tyrrell Hatton is healthy. And if you make that assumption, he would be very much underpriced at $9,100. So kind of in your mind, figure out the odds that he is fully healthy. I know that's not a very easy thing to do without any information, but, like, I think that's the way you play it there. For cash games, I do not like to play the assumption game, and I think that that makes it a little bit tougher for me to go with Hatton. He's in an okay tier. There are guys around him who I think are very viable and very interesting. So for cash games, I am wary of him, and I have alternatives to go to. So I don't think he'll make the cut for me in cash games. But I agree with you where the tournament appeal is really good. And, like, after he won, he said that that wrist had been bothering him ever since, like, the 2017, I think it was the Masters. It had been bothering him for a while. He said he was feeling better. So, like, that to me is encouraging despite the, you know, operation. So I am intrigued by Hatton for sure. And I'm willing to go there in tournaments, just not cash games.
Yeah, I think he'll be a super volatile play for a lot of reasons, and he could be one of the cheap golfers who does carry significant ownership. Maybe people aren't fully cognizant of the injury, so he's gonna be someone who I have to track the ownership of. If he gets up to, you know, again, there's usually a golfer in like the mid 30s in ownership to lead the pack, and then it bumps down to like 25%. If he's like 25% owned because he's so cheap, I might just avoid him and kind of play the angle that he struggles, but it's going to be a wait and see depending on the sentiment for him.
Yeah, I think that I'm way more willing to fade the chalk when there is a legit reason to be concerned. With Hatton, there is. So I would also be keeping an eye on that for sure, because if he projects to be popular, that's a time where you probably want to hit the eject button. And again, it's not a bad tier. There are other guys I like there too.
And one quick thing. He did put on his website this schedule that he planned on playing. He planned on kind of returning sooner than this. So that could be lingering. And, I mean, there's no cut, but there is withdrawal concern.
Yep. So keep that in mind for sure with Hatton, because there is definitely risk there, but the upside is there enough to justify checking him out for tournaments.